After two steady weeks in the MTN Soccer Academy School's Challenge 3 house, the teammates have so far warmed themselves into the competition with some decent and competitive displays both on and off the pitch. Welcome to the Weekly Highlights Show, a comprehensive update of teammates' activities over the week in the Soccer Academy house. After the break, the teammates take us through another week in the house. Stay tuned. There were two five-a-side games this week with Team MTN winning both matches convincingly. After losing the first game, Team Metro TV vowed to redeem themselves in subsequent games, but that could not materialize as they were dazzled by the sheer speed and shooting prowess of Team MTN.
That's a nice shot from Ninoy Thompson.
They are very, very well organized, and I think they are playing a very good game today.
He shoots one from there, and that's really great. Whoa, what a nice goal. What a nice goal from Ayini. That's really nice.
I've told you about this boy Ayini. The other 13 inmates should be very careful. Okay, but it was just that he used a very wrong technique that sent the ball over the touchline.
Malik shoots, and it's a goal. And that's a lovely one from Malik.
They get themselves very reorganized and get back into the game. But these MTN people are now, they've shadowed the Metro TV people.
The MTN team will always be a step ahead. And that's a lovely shot from Festus. And I've been saying this boy is very, very, very dangerous.
And these two people are those who are now making the things very difficult for the Metro TV people. They are always stable on the field. I don't know why, because they always...
Quay shoots one, and that's a goal from the captain. I think this guy has a very good shot. And then the referee calls it a day. The game ends. The MTN team 5, Metro TV team 2.
Yeah, the game was very tough. As you can see, this is our second match with the Metro team. As you can see, the MTN team were really poised up. We wanted to win the game because last time they won us in a game show, and we told them that today we are going to be there on the field, and that's exactly what we did. So as you can see with my boys, we are very happy.
Yeah, I'm very happy today because my players always make my day. Actually, we promised them that we're going to beat them anytime we meet them on a game of play, and we actually delivered.
We started very well, like you said, but we were tactically indisciplined, you know, in the second half. I think our coach asked us to play like we played in the first half, but I don't know what happened. All of a sudden, you know, different players came in, and they were now trying to warm themselves into the game, and so they couldn't play as directed by the coach.
We played the better side, but then when it gets to the time to do the right thing, we failed to do the right thing. I think that is what caused our downfall today.
Well, I'll say thanks to God first. And we started the game very well. It was good in the first half. We were able to play, but when it got to the second half, I think there was a bit of deconcentration. You know, we lost concentration a bit, and our players were a bit tactically indisciplined.
Today, the MTM team is the better team today too, because they started very slow, but later on came to the game, and then you could see the combination, the interpositional changing, the creativity and everything. I think I will congratulate them. And with my team, they started very well, and all of a sudden, they all go down. I think they still need to work hard to catch up with the MTN team.
I don't know defeat. And 10 times I will beat them. 10 times I will beat them. We have a strategy, and the boys are working very hard. They shoot, they come back to start again. So the attitude, the way they go towards the game, I like it very, very much. And every game, I believe we will win.